Hi everyone, today our topic is vendor configuration, defining vendor number range and the vendor master creation. So before starting the video, I would like to share you some information regarding the vendor master. That what is a vendor master? It is a most important file that contains the information on a supplier that is required for purchasing any material. The vendor file is the sole location for the information on each of the vendor for a company, right? The record in the vendor master should be correct, checked and updated regularly to ensure that most accurate record are used. So that is called, this is the definition of the exact vendor master. So it is a what I have defined right now, the vendor master. So let's again go with the definition of the vendor. What is vendor? The vendor is a person or a company who supplies material or service to the person or a company required those material for service. So for defining the vendor account group, we have the T code of /NOBD3, enter. So here we have to define the vendor group. So in that one, we used to define that what kind of supplier, what kind of vendor it is. It a one time vendor or a domestic vendor or a import vendor, like that we used to define over here. So for that sake, what you have to do, you have to click on new entries, just go over here and click the code, what kind of code you want to do. But I would like to say you one thing, the vendor which has already created, just make it copy from here. Just like click on position TX01. See the TX01, 2, 3, 4, these all the vendors I have created. Again, I'll create the new vendor. For that, why I'm saying that, because if I'll open it, this having multiple field status that contains multiple data, right? Like we have to enter general data, company data and purchasing data. If we'll double click on the general data, the address which I want to make required entry, optional entry or only display or suppress, right? So like this kind, we can make in everything, in address, communication, control, payment terms and contact person. See communication here having the same thing, what I required the that is required entry, or that see the landline I want to make required entry or optional entry or display entry. The same thing I can mention over here. If I click on the language is required entry, while creating the vendor master data, the checkbox we can get the appearance of the checkbox. That means we should fill the language compulsory. If I make it optional entry, that is not in the master data, it will not so compulsory, right? So like that we can create. So vendor account group, what I am going to do, I'm just going to make it copy, just selecting it, and vendor account group XX01, right? Save. This is a one time vendor. Again, click on copy XX02, make it import vendor. Click enter, click on save. See like this kind I have created two vendors, right? X01 XX02. So by using this, I'll create a vendor data. But before creating the vendor master data, we need to define the number range of the vendors. For that sake, what I have to do, /NXKN1, check interval, what I need, I want to assign some few intervals over here, like 23, 23, 28, and 32 that I want to assign, or just 2. So for assigning, what I have to do, slash in obas, click on position xx01. What's the number range? The first one is 23. In second one, I'd like to add 28. By this, it is assigning with the number range, right? So now what I have to do, I have to go for creation of vendor master. So before going to the creation of vendor master, I would like to say one more important thing, that reconciliation account. You need to create reconciliation account in fs00, actually it is a code of creation of GL account. See, in this I have already created a reconciliation account, so it is not required to create over here. While creating the vendor master, I'll show you the which account I have created. Like this, you'll have to create in the same T code fs00. So what is the T code of creation of vendor master, the centrally? So the T code of creation of vendor master centrally is xk01, right? So let's enter xk01, click here. Company code, what is my company code? Company code is 5121 that I have created in my previous videos. 51PO, account group xx01 that I have created right now. See, what's the name I want to give this company? MSJYOTA Jyoti Turbo Power Services Private Limited. Right. I want to give the name JTPS. I have explained the search team, what is the search term in my previous videos. I'll give the link on description for letting you know about the search term. You'll check by the clicking on the link which is given in the description. See, enter the house number or street that you want to enter. I'm giving it the Nagar Palika Market. Its address, house number 487, that's postal code 822101, and the thing is city Daltonganj, country IN, region JHA Jharkhand. The use of last 5 character name 1 is restricted, 36 to 40. Make it company. Enter customer click on enter reconciliation account. See, here it is, one of the most important thing that you need to enter, and I have told you that I have already created the reconciliation account, the 999, that one I have already created. Payment term. So what's called payment term? That means payment term is defined by you, that what type of what duration you want to take the payment from the vendor, or what duration you want to take the payment from the customer, instantly or within after few days, or after if you'll keep after few days, like 10 days, if the vendor will pay you within 10 days, so you'll not charge any amount. If the vendor will exceed more than 10 days or 20 days, you will charge 10% or 5% of cash discount, the interest that you will add, or if he will give you the payment within the date, or so you can give the discount in that case. So I'm selecting immediate. Click on enter. Order currency INR. Payment term. Again, I need to select the payment term. 0001. Click on enter. Click on enter. Yes. So my vendor has been created. I'll show you by creating a purchase order by this slash NME21N. Here I have enter purchase organization. What is my purchase organization? 51PO 5121. Enter. I need to insert the purchase group. So what I have created the purchase group in my previous video is 51P. See, all the data I have, what I am filling over here, it is created in my previous videos. You can get the link on my description, which is given, right? So see the material. First of all, I have to insert the material. So I just forget the name of the material. So I'll insert the material type. What I have created in my previous videos, the material type is F. Yeah, this is the material type what I have created. Click on enter. So I'm selecting the camshaft, right? The PO quantity is 10. Net price is 1000. 5000 is plant code. Storage SL01 that I am going to enter over here. See, what is asking? Account assignment category, that K for cost center. Given delivery date. Select the delivery date, whatever you want, or at what date the vendor can deliver you. See, just neglect the error what is given over here. Click on enter. Click on save. Yes, I want to save. See, my new purchase order has been generated. That means the configuration what I have did for the material in the previous video and the configuration what I have did for the vendor in this video is correct. And for the my upcoming videos, I will show you how to purchase a material from the vendors. If the vendor will give you some conditions, like if you will get this much of material, I'll give you, if you will purchase the 10 quantity of material, I'll give you 2 quantity free. So how can I return the material to the vendor? That means return purchase order, that each and everything I'll show you in the next video. So thanks for being with us, and please do subscribe my channel and like this video and click on bell icon so that you can get the notification while I'll upload the new video. Thank you.